Hej Allihopa, and welcome to my big Swedish adventure. I'm riding the length of Sweden from north to south. In the previous episode, I rode deeper into the Swedish countryside, saw some cool old American cars, rescued a Swedish flag from the side of the road, camped near a beautiful lake, and I'm excited because I've done more than half of the adventure, and I've got about 700 miles to go.
Well, this is a lovely place to wake up. Wow. Sunshine. I dig it. Although I was looking last night on the weather app, and it doesn't look good for the next few days. Rain, rain, rain. And on this lovely Friday morning, I'm gonna have some apricots, banana, and some trail mix. Thank you, beautiful lakeside camp spot. This one, for some reason, has a special place in my heart. I really like this one. And I've got the Swedish flag again. This is gonna be my good luck charm all the way down to the bottom. Let's do this. Oh, leg over the bike first thing in the morning is always tough. Ooh, my butt's a little tender. My legs are a little sore, but I'm good. It's Friday. Yeah, let's do this. No crashies, no flatties, no whammies. This is a nice way to start the day. A big old downhill. So I'll be honest. The weather forecast with lots of rain is spooking me a bit. Last week traumatized me, and I don't really want to deal with that again. But I also realized that I can't do anything about it. So I'm just gonna ride and see where I get. And if I need to find a hotel or something later on, I will. But for now, I'm just gonna pedal and not worry about it. Because when I worry, it takes me out of the enjoyment of right now, and right now is beautiful and sunny. So I'm not gonna let my fears take over. It's hard sometimes, but I'm gonna enjoy this right now, because right now is awesome. Morning, cows. Good morning. So I'm riding by this interesting looking church, and I'm like, I gotta check this place out. Look at this cool building. I don't think I've ever seen something like this. Looks like it's completely made out of wood. I'm glad I stopped here. That's the first really interesting piece of architecture I've seen on this entire ride. Fascinating. It's time for my morning Ica run. And here are this morning's goodies from the Ica supermarket. Bananas, a protein shake, I got some of these little French cheese ball things. Of course, my favorite protein bar. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And a tomato cheese sandwich.
Skål, allihopa.
Utfart, haha. I am utfarting away from Delsbo, nice little town here. And moving on out. Knee update. It's feeling much better today, which is a good sign. That makes me happy. It's never fun to ride with a nagging injury, because then you worry that it's gonna get worse and worse and get to the point where you just can't ride anymore, but I think I'm good. You know what I'm thinking about right now? I'm thinking about how grateful I am that I'm breathing in fresh, clean air. I was looking on the internet last night on my phone, and it looks like a lot of the United States, at least Chicago, New York, the Midwest, is engulfed right now in really yucky air from the Canadian wildfires. And we've definitely had this in Boulder as well throughout the years. And it's a bit of a new normal here in the summer, in the United States at least, and it's such a bummer, and just goes to show what's going on here with climate change. Growing up, we never had to deal with bad air quality because of forest fire smoke, ever. This is just in the last 5 years or so. And I know later this summer in Boulder, it's gonna happen. There's gonna be some forest fire smoke that's gonna shut everything down, and then it's just unhealthy to go outside and run and bike, which is such a shame because I love summertime in Boulder. Summertime anywhere. So I'm really grateful right now that I'm breathing in the fresh Swedish air. But even here it can happen. There's actually a fire ban in the entire country because it's been so dry. There's been some massive forest fires in Sweden as well. So it's coming for us all. By this little red shack, and I was like, I have to check this out. And you know what it is? It's a little cute Swedish bus stop. And look, it even has some flowers and a cute little boot. And look at this thing. So cozy. You can sit here safe from the rain. And you have your own little shack, even a cushion on the bench, place to wipe your feet, an old road sign. There's even a cute little window here with glass. I love this. Sweden does it right. My goal is to find one of these later today when the rain starts. This would be absolutely perfect. So cozy. So as I'm sitting here in my favorite little Swedish bus stop bench, another bike touring adventurer rolls by. What's your name?
Hi, I'm Koen, and I'm from the Netherlands.
And where did you start your adventure?
I started in the north of Netherlands, Groningen, and now on my trip for 30 days. And the plan was go to North Cape, but I don't know yet. And yeah.
What's been the best part of it?
The best part is, well, here in Sweden and in Denmark, you have like these free shelters at lakes, sort of like this, where you can just sleep and camp and swim. And yeah, I really love it in nature. So
that's cool. What's been your favorite Swedish food?
I'm really easy. The sandwich with the shrimps they sell here, like pre-packed. They make it daily, and it's with a lot of shrimps and egg and some dressing. So
that sounds good.
Yeah, I'm not a chef cook, so I make easy pasta and Uncle Ben sauce.
Nice. And this is your bike right here. Got all your stuff.
Yeah, it's
you've got a roll-off hub. Ooh, you have a Gates carbon belt drive. Look at that. Just like me.
Yeah, I bought it for my... I did a trip before this in 2016 when I cycled from the Netherlands to Indonesia and back.
Wow. And, how long did that one take?
3.5 years.
Jeez, that's incredible.
So this is a much shorter trip of 3 months. So, but yeah, the bike is great. I love the roll-off hub, and the belt is still good for 40,000 kilometers. So
wow.
I can advise everybody to take a belt if you want <That's> if you cool. hate maintenance.
So. Yeah. And what's your favorite part about traveling by bike?
Just meeting the people, yeah. If you go slow on a bike, so people speak to you instead of like when you rush by on a moped or on a car.
Great to meet you, Koen.
Good luck, man.
Enjoy this little summer cabin.
Oh, what a good dude. I'm so glad I just happened to stop there. I actually rode past it and then turned around. I'm like, I gotta check that place out. I was there for about 5 minutes and then he rolled up. I always enjoy meeting other bicycle travelers and hearing their stories. And man, he rode all the way from Holland to Indonesia. That's a long way. And his next dream trip is the Great Divide in the United States. So I told him all about it. Those clouds are starting to look like they're developing into something pretty mean. Oh boy. Gonna rain, this got regna in about 3 seconds, and I just worked out a pretty sweet deal here at this campsite. I'm gonna show you. I'm pretty happy about it, and it's cheap, 20 bucks. There is my home for the night. I rented an RV. You ready to check this out? Dun 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 dun. Oh yeah. I even have a crystal chandelier. Check it out. So cozy. All I really care about is that I have a roof over my head. I'm happy. I didn't get the miles that I wanted to today. I was hoping for 90 to 100, only went 60, but I just don't want to ride in the rain all afternoon. So I'm treating myself to a night in an old Swedish RV, and I'm pretty happy about that.
By the sounds of it out there, I obviously made the right decision. I've only been here 20 minutes and it's starting to pour. So I'm gonna sit in here and be cozy. It's only 1 p.m. I've got the rest of the day to chill. Unfortunately, it is supposed to rain for the next like 2 or 3 days. So we will see what happens when I start heading south. But for right now, I am happy and cozy. RV happy dance. I'm in the RV and I'm dancing because I'm not getting wet, and it was only 20 bucks.
And there's even power so I can catch up on charging batteries.
Well, I've been here about 6 hours now, just waiting out the rain. I've managed to charge all my stuff, and during one of the breaks, I raced into town and got some loose goodies. This is like loose candy. It's kind of like Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory style. You go into these stores and they have all these bins full of candy, and you have a little scooper and you just choose whatever you want. So I got a bag of candy for my rainy day. I am grateful for today. I am grateful for my health. Even if it's a rainy, cloudy day, I'm having fun. I'm on an adventure. I'm living out a dream. I'm in Sweden, my beloved Sverige. And it's all gonna work out, because it always does.
Oh boy, I slept so well. So well. Gosh, this is the best RV bed ever. It rained a lot last night. It's not raining now though. I guess I need to get up and go. So this is what I'm looking at. Rain all day. And then looking forward, rain till Tuesday.
Whew, there are some mornings you wake up and you just don't want to go outside. And today is one of those days.
Thank you, awesome old RV. You are a lifesaver. Man, I am so thankful for that RV. Made life a lot more comfortable yesterday. Here we go, I slept well, it's Saturday morning, I'm in Sweden, I'm going to Malmo, life is good, I might get wet, that's okay. No crashies, no flatties, no whammies. And maybe I'll get lucky and have no rain ease. And today is July 1st. And on the first of every month, I always say rabbit, rabbit, right when I get up, because it brings me good luck for the rest of the month. So rabbit, rabbit, everybody. It's another silly thing that I do. I'm not the only one. Lots of other people do it. Gotta make every day fun somehow, right? Better, mainly because it's dry and I'm dry and I'm on a quiet road. Look at that. In Sweden, they even warn you about frogs crossing the road. Smågrodorna, smågrodorna. I love it. Sweden's so cute. Hey look, Komoot finally gave me some real gravel. Right on, I've missed the sound of my tires crunching little rocks. You know what it's time for? Time for a little cheese ball, because I'm a little cheese ball. I'm a lot cheese ball. I remember getting these when I was an exchange student and I thought they were so fancy. You like peel the wax off and you have this French cheese in there. Mm-mm. Open that up like this. It's hard to film this and do this with one hand, but I will persevere. There's my cheese ball. Mmm. I'm the only one out here today. Where is everybody? Hello! This has been a great day. Like, no cars, gravel roads all day. No rain so far. It's been quite pleasant. Thank you.
I am out here today in the woods on a beautiful gravel road. So I'm out here acting like a total goofball like always. And you've heard me talk about love shoutouts, where I just shout out love to people in my life. Like this, I love you, Mom! And I just go through everybody I love. And today, I actually started filming little love shoutouts on my cell phone so I can send it to them so they can actually hear me. You know, I have a pretty loud voice, but when I shout out here, I don't think my mom is hearing it. Maybe she feels it, I don't know. Oh, look what I just found. A little shelter. Ooh, with a very fancy piece of woodwork in the middle here. Hope I find one of these or something like this at the end of the day. I would camp in here in a flash. Thank you, awesome shelter. That's a good place to hang for a second. Eat some nuts. Oh, it seems like the rain has stopped, which is very nice. I'm heading right for that darkness. Oh boy. Is that sunshine I see? A little bit of blue sky? I'm seeing sun right over my head. I'm not sure I believe it, but it feels sunny, feels warm.
Look what I just saw off the side of the road. Look how tall that midsummer pole is. That's pretty sweet. Yeah. A lot of dancing under that one. The whole town gets together, runs, dances under that. Very cool.
Oh boy, this sun feels good. I took off my jacket. I put on sunscreen, got my sunglasses on. It might be short-lived because the clouds still look pretty threatening, but right now is a good moment. There's a wedding happening right now and they're taking photos and I just rode my bike right behind them. I wonder if I'm gonna be in the back of their wedding photos. How cool would that be?
Look at this supermarket treat. We've got tomatoes and mozzarella, and I'm really looking forward to it. I always feel better after a little bit of food, and I'm looking off into the sky that way. Uh-oh, looks pretty dark. Is it gonna rain? I don't know. There's only one way to find out.
All right, here we go. Let's get into this. Let's see what happens. The temperature has dropped quite a bit. That always happens right before it's gonna rain.
This is really a beautiful area. These are some of the nicest red summer houses I've seen on the trip.
Look at that guy. It's perfect, right out of a fairy tale.
Well, the rain finally caught up to me. Luckily, there's this little house with a some sort of a patio with a roof, and I just rushed over here off the side of the road, and I'm gonna wait it out because it's raining pretty hard now. It's funny to think that just 30 minutes ago I was taking off my jacket and putting on sunscreen. Maybe I was getting cocky, or maybe it was just wishful thinking. Thunder. One of the first Swedish words I ever learned was Oska, which means thunder, because at the time my Swedish sister's boyfriend was named Oscar. Oscar. Thunderman.
Okay, I have been waiting here for an hour, a lot longer than I thought, and it's still raining, but I'm getting antsy, so I'm just gonna get wet.
thank you. Wonderful patio. Whoever owns this place, you're awesome. Well, I was able to avoid rain for a good part of the day, but not all of it. And I pretty much knew I was gonna get wet at some point, so here I go, getting wet in Sweden. Yeah! I thought I waited out the heaviest part of the rain. I sat there for an hour, but it's still coming down pretty good. But as long as I keep my legs moving, I'm staying pretty warm. Just gotta keep moving, keep moving, keep singing dumb songs. Sommartider, hey, hey, sommartider. Ge mig din hunger, ge mig din hand. Oh, ge mig allt du vill och allt du kan. Bra, bra, bra. Where'd the sunshine go? It was so nice. I put sunscreen on. Whatever. This day's gonna turn out great. At the end of the day, I'll find somewhere cozy to stay. And it's been an awesome day. No doubt. Rain can't rain on my parade. Rain. The rain sounds really pretty in the forest. It sounds kind of like shh, hitting all the leaves and the pine needles. There's a beauty in being out here alone on my bike in the rain. Again, these are the days that are memorable. I don't forget these days. And when you make it through one of these tough days, you feel really good about yourself. And that's awesome. Looky, looky, rain's gone, rain stopped for now, and I feel really good, really good. Sometimes you just gotta go through it, you gotta face your fears. You know, even me, I've been on tons of adventures and I've been in lots of precarious positions. I still get spooked by inclement weather. I don't like being wet and cold. But I went out there and I realized, oh, it's just rain. You know, when we were kids, we loved jumping around in puddles and playing in the rain. It kind of brings back that childlike joy to get wet. And now I'm dry. It is 6 p.m. I've gone 92 miles. I started at 7 in the morning. I feel good. I feel dry now. The rain is gone. And I'm gonna ride a little bit more. There's a town up here called Borlänge. And I'm gonna find a place to stay. Hopefully with a roof, because they're calling for rain all night. Olé, 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 olé. Big old fat rain. Damn. Woo! Come on, Mother Nature, give me a break! So I raced to get to this hotel here, and she just said they don't have any rooms, and there's probably no rooms in the entire city because it's a big soccer tournament. I've just ridden 170 miles. I can't even talk. I've ridden 107 miles so far. So I want to be done. I don't know what I'm gonna do if there's no hotels. Just keep going, maybe camp in the woods. No, 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 no. Oh, I don't even know what to do. My brain is fried. I have something in my eyeball. It's all red. I'm tired. I'm wet. I was just hoping to plop into a hotel. But yeah, there's no hotels. I just checked online. There's nothing in this town.
So I am just gonna keep on riding. I'm in Sweden, there's a lot of light, so I'm just gonna keep going until I find something. I just gotta laugh to myself. Here we go, it's 8 p.m. I've been riding since 7. And this is sometimes what happens in adventures. You just gotta figure something out. So I'm figuring. You know what, I'm starving. So I'm gonna get some food. That'll make my brain work better and then keep on going. How about some pizza? That sounds good.
Whoa, check that out. I usually like to have my accommodation worked out earlier than 8 p.m. and I'm still not done, but you know what? I feel good that I've just stopped and I have food and I'm just gonna work things out and keep on moving and I'll find something. It sounds crazy, you know, but luckily there's a lot of light here. I can ride pretty late and find a spot. I was really hoping to get a hotel, but I don't think it's gonna happen. But something else, maybe even better, will happen. This tastes so good. I love all those protein bars and treats, but something special about warm food.
Thank you, Pizzeria and Oselby. Man, that was good. Yum, yum, yum. Okay, I feel a lot better. Back on the road, back on the hunt to find a place to camp for the night. So I came off route about 4 miles just to go into Borlänge to get a hotel. So now I'm going back to the route and then I will continue and see what's down the road. I'm just scanning everywhere. Not a lot of people on the streets right now to talk to and ask, but I'll find something. Ni är jättesnälla. Hejsan, jag heter Ryan. Och jag var en utbytesstudent i Sverige för jättelänge sedan. Och just nu cyklar jag hela Sverige. Från Kiruna till Malmö. Jag ska hälsa på min värdfamilj i Malmö.
Åh, vad härligt.
Ja, det är jättehärligt. Men idag har det varit tufft. Med regn och allting.
Well, I found a roof. I was just riding by. Not many people are out. It's kind of late. And this guy was getting his mail. And I just said, hey, is there anywhere around here I can sleep under just a roof or something? And we talked for a bit. And he's like, yeah, you can just sleep on my outer room here. The ute room. And so this is where I'm going to be for tonight. And I am very, very glad. Happy, happy, happy. Okay, it's time for some more Swedish trail magic. These are my new angels, Margarit and Lassie.
Tack så jättemycket, ni är så snälla.
And we are sitting here just catching up. We had some tea. They made me some nice warm tea. Saved me from a long day and rain. And vi pratar om Sverige, va?
Yes.
Och allting som är svensk. And they're like, we see cyclists go by all the time, but you're the first one who's actually stopped here.
Du åker skidor?
Alpint, ja.
Alpin, och
jag var med i svenska landslaget från 62 till 70.
Wow. Imponerande. Ja. Och du tävlade mot Ingmar Stenmark?
Eller? Ja, i slutet av min karriär så började Ingmar.
Okay.
Så jag har tävlat mot Ingmar.
Okay. Vem vann?
Ingemar.
So I'm learning that Lasse is a little shy to brag about himself, but he was at the Olympics twice. OS, två gånger.
Ja, tävlar själv på OS två gånger. Innsbruck 64, Grenoble 68.
Look at all of his trophies. This is amazing. So much gold. And this is probably the mascots from the Olympics in those days. What a day. Big miles, big rain, big trail magic. I am so tired. It's like 10:30 p.m. Oh, but man, these are the good ones. These really are. These are the good ones that I will always remember and hold close to my heart. And to end it with meeting this wonderful couple, it doesn't get any better than that. And they're going to make breakfast for me in the morning. Good night.
Oh man, it is really raining now.
Hello there, and thank you for making it to the very end of this video. You get a high five.
I am here to say, hey, thank you for watching my videos, but also, if my videos bring value to your life, if you love them with all your heart and soul, or even just a little bit of your heart and soul, please consider joining my Patreon. You will help keep this channel alive, but you will also get stuff. You will get early release videos with no ads, which is very cool. And I sometimes do Zoom calls with my patrons. You will have direct access to me through Patreon to ask me any question you want. And like I said, you're keeping this channel alive. And also, hey, I wrote a book. It's called The Long Way Home. It's about my very first adventure from Honduras to Colorado. And it talks a lot about how it inspired me to live an interesting life, to say the least. My mom loves it, so maybe you'll love it too. I will link all this down below. But more than anything, thank you so much for watching my videos. You are awesome. Now it's time for you to get off that couch and get out there.
Oh God, what happened? It started raining like crazy. It was so nice 5 minutes ago. Oh man, it is really raining now. Oh.